Are you a human being between the ages of 0 and 200? Vulcan's to Spock. Have you ever spoken to or made eye contact with a member of your same gender?
Mr. Spock, you're a stubborn man.
Are Gene and I even remotely aware of your existence?
I have to take it back inside myself.
Then you've been slashed.
1, 2, ready, go!
Gene and I have a serious slash addiction. What percent of our time is devoted to talking about or creating slash? How much of our hard disk space is taken up by slash? How out of sync are we with our local time? Because we stay up all night engaging in slash. I'm looking at me, Sage. And this isn't limited to your classics such as Kirk Spock, Janeway 7, Dan and Phil, but also
it's Dracob. That means Draco and Jacob. Yeah, it's Dracob. They're so in love.
And even more bizarrely, our latest fetish, fire sticks. Clearly, the lack of all even remotely aroused body language indicates true love. Why all the awkward, Dan? Covering up a crush? Because in our book, you're gay until proven straight. This all began when I was an innocent high school student. See, I met this guy, Steve, at a party, and it was love at first. Recognition that you might be gay. But unfortunately, I was dating poor old Jay. Now, a few months later, I was able to negotiate myself into an open relationship with said Jay. And lo and behold, and yet, even though I was head over tits for this boy, I was still... Are you gay? Are you sure? You know, if I were gay, I wouldn't necessarily know right now. But are you sure you're not gay? And by college, this casual gay enthusiast had become a full-blown addict. So there was this group of incredibly awkward boys, Abs for short, who I'd sort of worked my way around, picking and nibbling at their Abby wonders. And even while sexually engaging with these fine gentlemen, it was perfectly reasonable for me to think them gay. First, there was, let's call him John Murder SpongeBob and his good friend, Randy Lou. Randy Lou. And often, they would head off to the mountains for the weekend. Which is a perfectly reasonable thing to do, because I mean, we were going to school in Vermont. But for Gene and me, it was clear.
You don't go out there and fish.
You don't know nothing about it.
But Lou wasn't John's only slashy potential. Oh no, John was the belle of the slashy ball.
Big balls.
There was an Ab, let's call him Dick. Short for Dickolas, of course. Who I sort of ended up with throughout the rest of my college days. Does being in a long-term relationship with him exempt him from accusations of homosexuality? Not a chance. See, Dick was roommates with John. They even went to China together, which if you've ever read The Amber Spyglass, you know means only one thing. Sexual discovery, I'm discovering my sexuality. So, post-college, how has our slashing affected these fine gentlemen? Well, two of them have now engaged in confirmed homosexual experiences, and one is actively pursuing the gay scene. Gay until proven straight. Gay until proven straight. So ladies, if you find yourself asking, where have all the good men gone? Well, I can answer that. I drove them away from vaginas forever. Sorry, not sorry. So my OTP, cousins plus slash.
If you were gay, I'd shout, hooray!
I am not listening.
You know,
If I were gay, I wouldn't necessarily know right now. No pants.
Okay. Are our boobs almost touching?